The Greensleeves is obliged to sing. First, may I say that it is indeed an honor and a privilege for you to be here. Man don't sing for bread alone, Shakespeare. So I hasten to add that all proceeds from this album will come home. When you're old and tired of singing, you know where you can go. Many a bold and beautiful ladies have been immortalized in folk songs. Molly Malone, Fancy Carter, Aura Lee, Bo Peep. But my favorite is just plain Betsy. Oh, do you remember what Betsy was like? She crossed the big campus on her racing bike. She'd attend formal dances in sneakers of blue. She's the very first beatnik that I ever knew.
She's the very first beatnik that I ever knew.
She had Navajo bracelets, a bullfighter's flask, two bongos, one guitar, and a witch doctor's mask. Blackly attired, sloppy, an album by Saul, and an autographed copy of Das Kapital. Her hi-fi played opera at ear-splitting sound. She sang every folk song from Greensleeves on down. The wild abstract painting she knew at a glance, and she was expert at interpretive dance.
She was expert at interpretive dance.
When she finished school, Betsy said, "Listen, girls, before some square swine, I'm not casting my pearls. Now you can all marry, but that's not my goal. Like I'm off to Gay Perry to search for my soul.
Like I'm off to Gay Perry to search for my soul."
'Twas just 5 years later, I happened one day to visit the suburbs, and to my dismay, 'twas there I found Betsy, five kids and a spouse, two small cars, one big dog, and a split-level house.
Two small cars, one big dog, and a split-level house.
I said, "Let's cut out for some cool village den. We'll fall by and pick up on Cat's reading Zen, and dig some espresso, then ace out again." She said, "I don't guess so, I've stockings to mend."
She said, "I don't guess so, I've stockings to mend."
I said, "Grab your sneakers and let's make that scene." Said Betsy, "No thank you, the house I must clean." Then I take the kids to the dentist today, and I only wear sneakers when tennis I play.
I only wear sneakers when tennis I play.
So that ends my story of Betsy the Beat. She says she is happy and life is complete, but I heard her whisper as she closed the door, "It's like man, my..."